begin our worship by singing to God's praise in hymn number 1. All people that on earth do dwell, sing to the Lord with cheerful voice. Himself with mirth his praise forth tell, come ye before him and rejoice. Let us sing the 5 verses to the Lord's praise. Give you all a very warm welcome this morning to our service, and we pray for God's blessing to be with us here today. Next Sunday, both the Gaelic service is at 10 a.m. and the English service at 11:30 a.m. Should anyone wish to become a communicant member, they can also let one of the elders or let me know. And should anyone request baptism, they can also do the same. We pray for those who are unable to be with us through old age and infirmity. The Congregational Board met on Thursday, the 6th of October, and decided amongst things to do some fundraising events for the church. After the English service today, the Sunday School will provide a soup and bread lunch for the proceeds of the church fund. There will be a baptism at the English service next Sunday, the 23rd of October. Vivian Fraser Darrow, the daughter of Lorna and Ian, will be baptised here at the English service. Five new elders will be ordained at the joint Gaelic and English service at 11:30 on Sunday, the 6th of November. There are also item 12. You can see they're looking for various posts as follows. And if you wish you to be involved, please let the session clerk know. The gift appeal to date is £565. And the presbytery plan is at the back of the pew leaflet. These are all the intimations that I have to hand.
Oh.
Let us now sing in hymn number 58, thank you very much. If I come to Jesus.
Genesis chapter 32, reading from verses 1 to 21. Listen to the word of the Lord. Jacob also went on his way, and the angels of God met him. When Jacob saw them, he said, "This is the camp of the God." So he named the place Mahanaim. Jacob sent messages ahead of him to his brother Esau in the land of Seir, the country of Edom. He instructed them. "This is where you are to say to my master Esau, 'Your servant Jacob says, I have been staying with Laban and have been remained there till now. I have cattle and donkeys, sheep and goats, manservants and maidservants. Now I am sending this message to my lord, that I may find favor in your eyes.' When the messengers returned to Jacob, they said, 'We went to your brother Esau and now he is coming to meet you, and 400 men are with him. In great fear and in distress, Jacob divided the people who were with him into two groups, and the flocks and the herds, the camels as well. He thought, if Esau comes and attacks one group, the group that's left may escape. Then Jacob prayed, O God of my father Abraham, God of my father Isaac, O Lord, who said to me, go back to your country and your relatives, and I will make you prosper. I am unworthy of all the kindness and faithfulness you have shown your servant. I had only my staff when I crossed this Jordan, but now I have become two groups. Save me, I pray, from the hand of my brother Esau, for I am afraid he will come and attack me, and also the mothers and their children. But you have said, I will surely make you prosper, and will make your descendants like the sand of the sea, which cannot be counted. He spent the night there, and from what he had with him, he selected a gift for his brother Esau: 200 female goats and 20 male goats, 200 ewes and 20 rams, 30 female camels with their young, 40 cows and 10 bulls, and 20 female donkeys and 10 male donkeys. He put them in the care of his servants, each herd by itself, and said to his servants, go ahead of me and keep some space between the herds. He instructed the one in the lead, when my brother Esau meets you and asks you, to whom do you belong and where are you going, and who owns all these animals in front of you? Then you are to say, they belong to your servant Jacob. They are a gift sent to my lord Esau, and he is coming behind us. He also instructed the second, the third, and all the others that followed the herd. You are to say the same things to Esau when you meet him, and be sure to say, your servant Jacob is coming behind us. For he thought, I will pacify him with these gifts I am sending on ahead. Later, when I see him, perhaps he will receive me. So Jacob's gifts went ahead of him, but he himself spent the night in the camp. Amen, and God bless the reading of his word.
Let us pray. Eternal and ever-merciful God, the creator of heaven and earth, we were encouraged by the words, all people that on earth do dwell, sing to the Lord with cheerful voice, and said with mirth his praise forth tell, come ye before him and rejoice. We have many reasons to be thankful and to praise your name. There are many others in despair today who have no food or clothing, many in Syria who are suffering, many in Yemen, much trouble all over the world. But you have the whole world in your hands. You created it, you control it, and you have power over all things. And we pray that peace would come throughout the land. As we're approaching nearly the time of peace that came to this great world in the birth of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. Blessed to us the reading of your word and the singing of your praises. We pray that if any be cast down, that you would lift them up. If many are fearful for their health, that you would heal them. We pray that your blessing would be upon all that we do and all that we say, and that the glory of God would be manifest in our midst today. We thank you for all the privileges that you give us in providence and in grace. We don't appreciate all your goodness to us. So gracious God, be near to us today as we continue to worship your holy name, as we pray together, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us sing in hymn number 366. Sing to the Lord a joyful song.
Reading is a continuation of the previous chapter, Genesis chapter 32, reading verses 22 to the end. Listen to the word of the Lord. That night Jacob got up and took his two wives, his two maidservants, and his 11 sons and crossed the ford of the Jabbok. After he had sent them across the stream, he sent them over all his possessions. So Jacob was left alone, and a man wrestled with him till daybreak. When the man saw that he could not overpower him, he touched the socket of Jacob's hip, so that his hip was wrenched as he wrestled with the man. Then the man said, "Let me go, for it is daybreak." But Jacob replied, "I will not let you go unless you bless me." The man asked him, "What is your name?" "Jacob," he answered. Then the man said, "Your name will no longer be Jacob, but Israel, because you have struggled with God and with men and have overcome." Jacob said, "Please tell me your name." But he replied, "Why do you ask my name?" Then he blessed him there. So Jacob called the place Peniel, saying, "It is because I saw God face to face, and yet my life was spared." The sun rose above him as he passed Peniel, and he was limping because of his hip. Therefore, to this day, the Israelites do not eat the tendon attached to the socket of the hip, because the socket of Jacob's hip was touched near the tendon. Amen, and may God bless the reading of His holy word.
Well, thanks very much to Mr. Alex Smith, one of the elders, for the reading, both readings today, and it's nice to see him back with us. We will now uplift the offering. Gracious God, we get many gifts from your hand, and we seek to give you all that we can and utilize our own gifts to the best of our ability. So accept the gifts that have been given today in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us sing to the praise of God in hymn number 96, Thou Hidden Love of God, and we can sing the four verses, thank you.
Thank you.
Let us turn now for a short time to Genesis chapter 32. Genesis chapter 32 and verse 26. Then the man said, "Let me go, for it is daybreak." But Jacob replied, "I will not let you go unless you bless me." And the man asked him, "What is your name?" "Jacob," he answered. Then the man said, "Your name will no longer be Jacob, but Israel, because you have struggled with God and with men and have overcome." Jacob and Esau were twins, and Jacob deceived his father for the birthright. They were twins, as I said, and Jacob had fled, but now 20 years had passed, and he was left Paddan Aram in obedience to having divine direction to return. This was the road which he had trodden as a fugitive 20 years before. His sin of deception of his father was ever before him. Now, it is true that he was entitled to the blessing, but he didn't wait for God's time to get it. He took it upon himself, with the help of his mother Rebecca, to get the blessing. So he fled from the hands of his twin brother, and indeed his brother Esau expected to get all the inheritance and get everything that was left to him. And because his brother had left everything behind and had just left, he pondered over these things day and night, starting on his journey and accusing his own conscience. You know, people can forgive us, God can forgive us. Sometimes we can't forgive ourselves for our own sins. But you know, if the Lord forgives us, that's what's important. Not what people think or what we think ourselves. But he couldn't grasp hold of the mercy, the goodness of God, and the promise of God that his sins was forgiven. And as he was approaching these hills of the land that he had left, in the distance, his heart pounding, having to face the brother, this patriarch was deeply moved with emotion, setting the scene before him, the memories flooding back to him. All the past rose before him very vividly, with the memory of God's favour to him and promises of divine help and guidance. And as he drew near, the thought of his brother, his twin brother Esau, brought troubled thoughts. Esau regarded himself really as the sole heir to the inheritance. And Jacob began to think, his brother is going to think that I'm coming back for what is rightfully mine. But he remembered that he sent a message ahead that the younger would serve the older. And this was in order that he would soften his brother by giving him the respect, "You are the older brother and we respect you, and I'm not here to take anything from you. I'm here to renew my covenant with you in a wonderful way." But then he sent him tokens and messages of kindness in order to win favour with his brother. But the news of Jacob's coming would stir up fear and anger with his coming to claim this inheritance, amazing as it was. He knew that his brother was able to do him a lot of harm, but the Lord was with him, which was more important. Jacob was surrounded by angels behind and before him and around him. Two hosts of angels were around him. Sometimes the angel of the Lord is around us too. Angels have not ceased doing their work, and we must never ever think that God's angels are still not ministering spirits in the world today. The Bible says that the angel of the Lord encamps and round about encampasseth all those about that do fear. The lion's young may hungry be, and they may lack their food, but they that truly seek the Lord shall not lack any good. Jacob remembered Bethel, the vision that he had there, and then it made his heart lighter. By divine messengers who had brought him hope and courage at his departure from Canaan, the land that was flowing with milk and honey. If you see on the Israeli flag, you see Egypt, and then you see the land there, and in between they have Canaan. It is interesting to see that he instructed the exact words to address his brother. The elder should serve the younger, thy servant Jacob. To remove fear, he sent oxen, asses, flocks, manservants, women servants. I have sent you this message to find grace in your sight. They returned to say that Esau's brother was coming with 400 men. Revenge can be sweet. You know, we've often heard the phrase said, vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. And you can say, I know, but give me a chance. I've said it myself, I must be honest. Revenge can be really sweet sometimes if you want to get revenge. And anger can be something that can really eat you up, and it can eat each one of us up if we let it. And if somebody's upset us that badly and we don't trust them or whatever, then it can really upset us. You can be in an isolated place with these situations, and it can be very, very difficult to forgive and forget. And somebody said to a minister once, how can you forget? Because every time you see that person, this thing comes up before you. It's like a warning sign. You know, you see this warning sign coming before you. You know that you're just uncomfortable. If you feel uncomfortable, you know, with something, let your heart speak and just say no. Just uncomfortable with the fact that you don't trust somebody or something, and you're just not sure of it. Think and then act. We then find that they could not go back or advance, and they were indeed unarmed, they were defenseless, and they were unprepared for a hostile encounter. Now that was very difficult, having to go to meet a brother, and he was unarmed, totally defenseless, and very unprepared for this hostile encounter. Jacob divided them into two camps so that one at least could escape. But then he sent generous presents as a friendly message. He did all in his power to atone the wrong to his brother. But you know, sometimes you can do everything, and only the Lord can do it in his own time. Doesn't matter what you try and do, it doesn't work for some people. And you can never get where you are. You can only try your best. And if it doesn't work, just give up. Let go and let God do it and try and sort it out. God will sort it out in his own time. Then he sent, as I said, these messages in humility, very humble, and indeed repentance, pleading for divine protection. One thing that he needed was divine protection, and he needed that from the Lord. But what did he do? He prayed. Verse 9, then Jacob prayed, O Lord, O God of my father Abraham, God of my father Isaac, O Lord, who said to me, go back to your country and to your relatives, and I will make you prosperous. I am unworthy of all the kindness and faithfulness you have shown your servant. I had only my staff. When I crossed this Jordan, but now I have become two groups. Save me, I pray, from the hand of my brother. Amazing how his prayer was felt unworthy of all God's kindness and faithfulness to him. So do we. We feel unworthy of that, often in our own lives as well, because of God's wonderful dealings with us. And then we find that he spent the night in prayer alone with God. Sometimes we need to be alone, sometimes you know that the phrase nowadays, and we needed our own space. Sometimes we need our own space just to gather our thoughts and to think, rather than just jumping into things. And the other thing was that he was in a place surrounded by wild animals, murderers, very unprotected, and nothing to fight off any enemy that was around him. But he had one person looking over him. He had God, and he prayed for guidance and for help. It was indeed midnight, and all that life had treated with him in the past was coming before him. Often when things are in the quiet time, you go over, things go 100 miles an hour in your mind. But with these earnest requests, he made his requests known to God. But then suddenly, a strong hand laid upon him. He thought it was an enemy, so he tried to escape this grasp that had come upon him. With all his might he wrestled, and not a word was spoken. The struggle went on till the break of day. Many of us have many struggles with our thoughts, with the enemy, but this was a struggle with God. And many of us have struggled with God because we ask God why things take place in our lives and why he allows things to happen to us in life. But God has a purpose for everything, whatever it may be. Sometimes we don't understand them, but it takes time, and maybe in its God's own time will reveal to us the things that he puts us through, that there's a reason for these things in our lives. This stranger placed his finger on his thigh and he became disabled. And he realized that it was a heavenly messenger sent from heaven. It was Christ who had revealed himself to Jacob. Disabled, suffering pain, he then pleaded for a blessing. And he said that he wanted to be let go. But Jacob said, I will not let you go unless you bless me. How many of us today would like this in our own hearts, to say to the Lord, I will not let you go until you bless me, until I have a blessing. With every blessing there comes a price. It shall cost, greatest blessing of all, cost his son his life. Jacob confessing his unworthiness, yet his worthiness was in Christ, and trusting in God's faithfulness in his own life. Jacob had not believed God's promises, and that was his big failing. We all have our struggles with self, with sin, self-forgiveness, and indeed trusting in God's promises. Jacob was seeking things in his own efforts to do things right and to bring it about, but then things are accomplished with God himself and his hand. The change of name was amazing, so that he wouldn't remember Jacob, who was indeed in the past. He was now Israel, forgiven, blessed, and going on his way in the strength of the Lord God to a new step, a new life, a new beginning for him in the world. His weakness had been made his strength. The wrestle represents the journey before each one of us in life. And this struggle is Satan, who indeed tests our faith, our perseverance, our confidence, and in God's power to deliver. Satan tries to make us believe God will overlook our unfaithfulness in minor affairs of life, but we mustn't ever forget that this is not true, and we do fail, and we faint, but God doth fail us never. The Lord shows us that he will in no wise cast us out. May God help each one of us today to ask him to bless us on life's way as we journey on from day to day with the Lord our Saviour. Amen. May God bless these thoughts to us today. Let us sing in hymn number 395. Hymn number 395. And Father of peace and God of love.
Thank you.
our Lord Jesus Christ, may the love of God and the communion and fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with each and every one of us, now and forevermore.